this is the Pondo Trail. Myself and Laura are taking on the adventure. It's a 3-day, 105-kilometer trail run. There's a lot of swims, there's a lot of mountainous areas and so forth, but we're gonna do it.
Start now, day zero. Well, this is day one of 3 days, but we're gonna do it. And we're here and we're amped and we're keen. This is the team.
Yeah!
David Greer, what are we doing here today?
Yeah, so the Pondo is an incredible challenge, and it's not about winning or getting there as quick as possible. It's about basically enjoying this journey and thinking about how can we make a difference to protect this incredible strip of coastline, and by doing that, enhancing the lives of the folk that live along this coastline so it can be preserved for generations to come. And we're part of it through the Miles of Smiles initiative. Last year we managed to put 23 kids through surgery through funds raised here. And already this year's surgical mission, we've found another 25 kids. So it's about that. It's about coming together, raising funds and making a difference in the lives of folk along the Pondo coastline.
And here we have a very dedicated Paul Miller. Paul, what's going on here today?
Morning. Listen, we're having an early start today. It's going to be an exciting one. 3 days ahead with a group of people that share a common purpose. I think that common purpose is all about making a difference and caring for life.
Guys, thank you very much.
Yeah, we took a wrong turn after the challenges and we went right inland.
How many k's did you do today?
Possibly five extra. Day two of the Pondo Trail. Because myself and Laura came last yesterday, we won the Vasco da Gama prize, which means that we went exploring. And now we made to wear these tutus.
Left on the table, and then the bus continues. Okay, so the back.
Mm-hmm.
trying to get over the pain and the shaving marks of yesterday. Let's try to make an impact on where we're going and what we're going to do with the books. So we can hand this out to the school year. And we're going to leave a little bit behind and something that they can be happy with and learn from.
Everybody taking part in the Pondoland Challenge are giving these books from the Pondoland Conservation Trust to these kids, and the smiles on their faces are absolutely amazing. How's it going? Patched up, ready to go, all smiles.
Man's got some kiss.
My knee is swollen, blisters under my feet. I've got a lot to complain about. And then you get these guys who, when did you guys set off? Last night at 11 o'clock? Last night at 11 o'clock they set off from where we started 3 days ago. My man Kia here is taking us over because it can get quite deep at the front here. But that said, there's a lot of people that did swim the whole thing over. I'm just a little bit sore. Thank you very much, man. How's it? Thank you. Thank you so much.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, guys.
Yay. Team Sipla.
My name is Kanisa Mambula. I am from Tsolo. And this is my daughter, Ayamkela Mambula. She's only 1 year old. She was born with a cleft condition. When I gave birth to her, I didn't know what the condition was. I was shocked. I was in denial. I asked myself a lot of questions. And I was blaming myself. I had depression, social anxiety. I couldn't go out. And when people came to visit us at home, I would take her to the room to avoid questions. Questions that I couldn't, you know, give to people, you know. And a lot of people told me that it was going to be impossible for her to receive a cleft, especially here in South Africa. There are no doctors who perform cleft surgeries to kids and everyone born with cleft conditions. I remember someone telling me that she's gonna get a surgery in this place, Japan, in Japan. And I was like, how am I gonna get to Japan? Others were like, go to Cape Town, she's gonna get a surgery there fast. And Operation Smile gave us a call. I didn't know about Operation Smile until they gave us a call. She was only 6 months, and they told us that she's gonna receive free cleft surgery from Operation Smile at Nelson Mandela Hospital in October 2022. They are such amazing people. They changed my life, they changed my daughter's life and my family's life as well, because it was just a lot to us, and we were not sure whether she's gonna receive a surgery or not. But when Operation Smile called us, they just changed our lives, and our experience with Operation Smile was just amazing. They're such amazing people. Every one of them is amazing. They are so amazing. They gave us not just a surgery, but other things like toys to make it easy for abantwana to adapt, and not just for them to think about, okay, we're here for surgery. But it was just an amazing experience for them as well. And I remember she received a surgery, okay, let me just say today, and the following day she was eating. She was fine. She healed well. I would like to thank Operation Smile and everyone for making it possible for Operation Smile to perform such wonderful surgeries. You changed our lives, and may you continue helping others as well. Thank you so much.